One of the things that the NHL has made sure that they've done is down the stretch, a lot of games against division rivals and everything. Do you like the way they've set that up? As you get closer to playoffs, you keep playing teams that are right in the thick of things?
Yeah, I think it's good for everyone. It's good for the teams that are trying to gain points. You know, it's good for the fans who are following their teams and want to see them get a playoff push. So yeah, I think everyone benefits from that. And you know, we see it with us. We're in a good battle within our division, and we're going to see I think four or five games at least of our last six within our division. So I think that's a good thing.
Are you tired of seeing the Flyers? You see them again today, and then next weekend you'll see them, and there's a possibility you could see them again in the postseason. Have you had enough of the Flyers right now? Would you like to get a break from them?
You know what, it's not that bad. I think we're all used to it now, and that's pretty common that you see similar teams and the way things match up. But my first couple of years, I think we played within our division 8 games, so it was even more then. So I think this is probably even less than maybe prior. So I think this is fine the way it works out, and it just so happens that our division is pretty strong, and you know, there's a good chance we could end up seeing each other.
What do you need to do differently in this game as opposed to the last one to get a win?
Just finish it off. I think we did a good job for 2 periods, playing at a high pace and generating a lot. And I think 3rd period we kind of got away from our game a bit, and they took advantage of some momentum they got from penalties we took. So you know, just finishing it off the right way and just maintaining the way we played those first 2 periods, and I think everything should work out.
Are you extra motivated when you play them? Do they bring something out in you?
I think so. I think it's a big rivalry, and I think everybody gets up for those ones. There's a little bit extra in those games, and the emotion's high, the intensity, and those are fun ones to be in. So I think that's pretty normal. You can't always match that type of environment in every game. So when it comes around, I think it brings out the best in everyone and both teams, and that's what makes it so enjoyable to play those ones.
In New York, when you first came back after the first couple of games, you told me that you were trying to adjust your game a little bit and maybe not looking to initiate contact as much. Have you been able to do that, or are you starting to initiate contact a little bit more?
No, I think just kind of letting the game come to me a bit more. It doesn't mean that I initiated contact before all this stuff happened, because I don't think I did. I think I, you know, if there was traffic, I went in there, but I wasn't necessarily looking to just show 3 or 4 hits a game, whereas I think the first time I came back, I was probably trying to test myself, and that's just kind of a natural thing that maybe some guys going through this will try to do, because you just want to make sure that you know, you're playing the same way, that you're not shying away. But at the end of the day, I think looking back at, you know, 6, 7 years I've played, it's, you know, I never really went looking for this anyway. So, you know, if the puck's there, you battle for it, and, you know, you take a hit or you give a hit in order to make the play, but you don't go looking for it. So that's something that I just tried to let the game kind of come to me a bit more.
Against the Devils, there was you took a pretty good shot against the boards. You got in the corner. Do you think, have you sensed that the teams are playing against you any differently than you did? There was a couple articles written where some people had said maybe some of his colleagues on other teams are maybe not looking to hit you when they have an opportunity, or maybe in the past they would. Have you noticed that at all?
No, I mean, I think as a league, I think as players, I think it's gotten a lot better. I mean, we always see, you know, the obvious, you know, suspensions or fines when there's headshots. But I think as a whole, I think guys have, you know, really taken upon themselves to, you know, to kind of try to eliminate that as much as they can. So I don't feel like anyone's avoided hitting me. It doesn't feel that way. It'd be nice if it felt that way, but it doesn't feel that way. But that being said, I think guys have really, you know, made a good attempt to stay away from hitting guys to the head, and I feel like that there hasn't been any targeting in my head or anything like that, even more so because I've gone through that. I haven't seen that at all.
The last couple of questions. Speaking of intensity and hitting, and that all ramps up in the playoffs. How excited is it like going back, because you had to miss last year's playoff? What are your senses? What are your sensations like as you start thinking about the postseason? I know you're still focused on the end of the regular season, but to have that opportunity to play back on the game's biggest stage.
Yeah, it's exciting. I think you just get that sense of preparing, and you know, the playoffs are a different atmosphere, a different environment. But you know, I think leading up to it too, the anticipation is also the fun part, because you know you're working towards getting to that point where it just kind of becomes automatic, and all those habits you work on over the course of a year, that's when you see them is in the playoffs. So. You know, in my case, I'm only going to play 14, 15 games here, so trying to cram, you know, trying to make sure that all those details are where they need to be. And so that's really where my mindset is, and that's fun because you miss that preparation, you miss, you know, making sure that everything's where it needs to be. That's the fun part of the challenge that comes with it. So I think just the anticipation, and then once it comes, just the challenge of you know, having to win every night, but it's tough, and that's what makes it so fun.
A challenge today may be avoiding Marc-Andre Fleury on April Fool's Day. Is he the guy that you look out for most on a day like today?
Yeah, him or Cookie, but I think April Fool's is a time when, you know, the guys that don't usually do anything can probably step up and do something and get away with it, so I don't know.
Would you be looking to be one of those guys to step up?
You never know. If it comes to me, if something comes to me, I'm sure. But yeah, those two guys, Flower, Cookie, will be the guys that guys are definitely have their head on a swivel for. But you know, there's always going to be a star that might come out. So we'll see who it is.